Hello everyone. So in this video of chapter alcohols, phenols and ethers, I'll be talking about the properties of alcohols and phenols. Physical properties of alcohols and phenols. Number one is nature of intermolecular forces. Alcohols and phenols are polar molecules due to the presence of OH groups. The polar OH groups are held together by strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding, or you can say hydrogen bonding. Another physical property, their physical state. Low alcohols are colorless, toxic liquids. They have characteristic alcoholic odor. Pure phenol is colorless, it is toxic, it is having low melting point when it is solid and having characteristic carbolic or phenolic odor. Another property is boiling point. Boiling points of alcohols and phenols increase with increase in their molecular mass. As branching increases, intermolecular van der Waals force become weaker and boiling point also increases. Therefore, N-butyl alcohol has the highest boiling point, that is 118 degrees Celsius, and tertiary butyl alcohol has the lowest boiling point, 83 degrees Celsius. Solubility. Phenols and lower alcohols up to 3 carbon atoms, they used to dissolve in water appreciably, and due to the formation of intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water molecules. Now, the chemical properties. Chemical properties. Number one, we will learn about the laboratory test of alcohols and phenols. And the first laboratory test is litmus test. Alcohols and phenols can be tested with litmus paper. Aqueous solution of alcohol is neutral to litmus. That means it is not changing blue litmus to red or red to blue. Whereas aqueous solution of phenol turn blue litmus red. That means we can say phenols have acidic character. Another reaction, reaction with base. Acidic strength of phenols are very low. Phenols do not react with sodium bicarbonate, but they used to react with sodium hydroxide. When you are adding aqueous sodium bicarbonate solution in phenol, you will see no reaction. But when you are adding sodium hydroxide solution into it, you will get to see the formation of sodium phenoxide, and on hydrolysis of sodium phenoxide with the dilute HCl, you will get to see the formation of phenol back with the formation of byproduct, that is NaCl. Alcohols show no acidic character in aqueous solution. Thus, alcohols do not react with NaHCO3 or NaOH. Very weak acidic character of alcohol is revealed in the reaction with active metal. Let's see. Alcohols used to react with active metal like sodium, and they used to form compound like sodium alkoxide along with the formation of hydrogen gas. And by this reaction, we can detect the particular compound is having OH or alcoholic group. Now, what is the characteristic test of phenols? Phenol used to react with neutral ferric chloride solution to give you deep purple or violet or green color of ferric phenoxide. Now, how would we distinguish primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols? It used to be distinguished with the help of Lucas reagent. And the test is known as Lucas test. Primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols can be distinguished from each other in the laboratory using Lucas reagent. And Lucas reagent is the mixture of concentrated HCl and zinc chloride. when this mixture is added to alcohol. Tertiary alcohol will react very fast, and you will get to see the turbid solution instantaneously. Within the moment you will get to see the turbidity in the solution. Secondary alcohols turns the reagent turbid, but slowly, not instantaneously, but slowly. And primary alcohols, after coming in contact with Lucas reagent, they will become turbid, but on heating. So on the basis of this test, we can distinguish primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols. Now we will be learning the reactions which is due to the breaking of OH bond. Number one is acidic character of alcohols and phenols. We got to know phenols by laboratory tests are weakly acidic, and it is clear that the reactivity of alcohol and phenols is toward ionization of OH bond in them is different. Ionization of alcohol is represented by this following equilibrium, where ROH or alcohol in presence of water, they will give you alkoxide and hydronium ion. Now, electron donating inductive effect of alkyl group destabilize the alkoxide ion. As a result, alcohol does not ionize much in water and behave like neutral compound in aqueous medium. Whereas phenols, ionization of phenol you are seeing here, on ionization it will produce phenoxide ion. Phenoxide ion is the conjugate base of phenol. So this conjugate base of phenol and phenoxide ion, in between these two a resonance stabilized by the delocalization of this negative charge. As you are seeing, there are so many resonating structure are seen on the screen. Therefore, phenol ionizes in aqueous medium to moderate extent and used to show the weak acidic character. Now, esterification reaction. Alcohols and phenols form ester by the reaction of carboxylic acid or acetic halide or acetic anhydride. The reaction between alcohol or phenol with carboxylic acid, due to the formation of ester, we will be calling such reaction as esterification reaction. For example, if this alcohol is reacting with one carboxylic acid in presence of hydrogen ion, they will be giving you compound having ester group. Similarly, if phenol is reacting with one carboxylic acid having hydrogen ion present in the reaction, you will be getting ester, which is a aromatic ester. Alcohols and phenols react with acid and hydrides in presence of acid as a catalyst to form ester. Like alcohol or phenol, they are reacting with acetic anhydride or any anhydride in presence of any acid. They will give you ester and they will give you one carboxylic acid compound as a byproduct. Similarly, if any alcohol is reacting with one acid chloride in the pyridine solution, they will be giving you ester along with the formation of HCl. Now, if a compound like salicylic acid is a compound where you will see in benzene ring there is a presence of COH group and OH group on ortho position. Orthohydroxybenzoic acid, when it is treated with acetic anhydride in presence of hydrogen ion or any acid, what will happen? This OH group will interact with this acetic anhydride, and on ortho position we will get to see one COOCH3 group, which is ester, along with the formation of ethanoic acid or acetic acid. This compound which is formed is called as acetyl salicylic acid, and the common name of this compound is aspirin. which is very well known generic medicine, and it is a acetyl derivative of salicylic acid formed by the acetylation using acetic anhydride. Other chemical properties due to the breaking of CO bond in alcohols we will be learning in next video. Thank you.